Jim, there is concern and question about a price war, and something certainly we're going to want to talk to Vestberg about as well. You know, there's some good money to be made from turning in your old iPhone to get a new one, but that sort of subsidizes things. And we've got three big competitors now. It's not like T-Mobile taking customers from Sprint anymore.
Nope, they're not. And I think they have a pretty darn good network. David, yesterday we spoke substantially about antitrust and about the notion that somehow Apple and Google have a tying opportunity that they've been abusing. David, if you had a price war, AT&T is the loser. It would be a price war where you'd have to identify whether they're actually giving it away below cost in order to terminate AT&T's ability to compete. Is there a possibility, David, that they could get to the point where AT&T can't spend enough to maintain its network? Because you see that there is a 7.7% yield for AT&T, and I find that anything north of 6 is unsustainable.
You do?
Yes.
You know, I don't know the answer to that. Certainly we know that AT&T has a very sizable debt load. They've got no trouble handling that debt load at present in terms of maintaining it, maintaining the dividend, given where they are in terms of how much cash they generate. They are also in the process of raising some money and offloading some debt. I've talked about the DirecTV transaction, which continues to move in terms of a potential buyer there for what would be not necessarily a majority of it at first, less than that, but nonetheless would be perhaps seen as a positive. Jim, maybe there's other asset sales that might be coming as well for AT&T. Unclear. Stanky has not given any real articulation of any plan on that front, but we'll see.
Well, what would happen if someone charged them, Verizon, with predatory pricing and T-Mobile with predatory pricing, which would their predatory price selling below their cost, which then knocks out AT&T?
You really think that's a possibility? You're really bringing up the idea that they would engage in some sort of price war to sort of force AT&T
to signal each other. Now, look, I'm not saying
cut his dividend.
Obviously, it's a violation of Sherman antitrust. So I'm not saying they'll do it. But you know what, David? A price war. It's not like, look, if Vestberg picked up the phone and called T-Mobile, no. But if Vestberg suddenly cuts rates big. Oh. And then
all fighting with each other. And again, we do have three now well-capitalized competitors.
Right. Well, look, I don't think it's going to happen. I'm just kidding. Carl, I look for situations where I can get more a 5% yield because that's about all that you can afford. 6%, I've been going over IBM. I think they can pay the dividend because I look at the cash flow. I think the cash flow is bountiful enough. I'm not worried about the dividend, but you know what? You say that, something happens. But I look at this AT&T dividend, and I don't know. 7.7 is not reassuring. It's a red flag, Carl. I don't want people in this one thinking, ooh, I can pick up a little extra income. Never reach for income, people at home. Never. Buy Verizon, 4%, very good. Kind of like a bond with a kicker. I don't want, Carl, I don't want people in something that may not, that it,
so,
it is risky.
To your point, ExxonMobil with it's coming up, 10.3% yield. Don't reach for that.
No, don't. Thank you for that.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.